Hey YouTube, it's Annabelle. So welcome to Veda Day number 24, and today's video is going to be on my mommy tips for kids' clothing. And now this is just how I do things and how I have found to work best for purchasing clothing, selling clothing, trading clothes, doing an inventory, storing, and caring for the clothes that we have for our kids. So if you've been following me, you know that I've done several videos on like my kids' clothes and my garage sale haul, how we buy clothes and how we inventory our clothes. So if you're interested in those videos, please go back and look at those. My daughter is 2.5 and my son is 6 months old, and so we have had to purchase girl clothing and boy clothing. Now when we were pregnant with my daughter, we did not find out her gender. So in the beginning, we bought a lot of gender neutral clothes, because what I wanted to do is I wanted to store them so that way our kids for like the future could wear the same like baby clothes. Now some people don't like their kids to wear the same clothes, and that's not a big deal, but we choose to like have our clothes like 0 to 6 months, we tried to buy as many gender neutral items as possible. And so what my daughter wore when she was little, my son wore when he was just like an infant, like 3 months ago. So it's very exciting to like have those clothes already. We didn't have to purchase new items. And again, with my daughter and with my son, of course, like my daughter, we purchased like girl clothes for her. And with my son, we were actually so fortunate enough for the first 6 months that we had family and friends that traded clothes with us, or actually like gave us clothes for my son to wear. And we had boxes and boxes for my son for the first 6 months of his life for clothes that he could wear that were like boy clothes. We had so many clothes, he could almost wear a different outfit every single day, multiple outfits per day, and we would still not run out of everything that our family and friends had given us. So that was truly a blessing. So how we do like buying clothes, again, we buy the majority of our kids' clothes used, and we do, again, we buy ahead. So I go to garage sales, yard sales, rummage sales, whatever you want to call them. I also go to some like secondhand stores and things like that to look at what they have for clothes. So one thing with buying clothes is you have to look at the quality of the clothes. Now, with my daughter, I was really worried about not finding something nice. So if a sale had clothes, I really didn't pay attention too much of the quality of the clothes. If they had a little stain on them, I bought it anyway. If it had a little rip on it, I bought it anyway. And with my son, I am not doing that. I'm very selective in the clothes that I buy used. They have to be really, really like good condition, like no rips, no holes, no stains, no fading, and just good quality clothes. So another thing with buying clothes is setting yourself a budget. Now, if you've seen some of my videos in the past, you know that like for infant clothes, so for under like 12 months, I don't like to spend more than a quarter or 50 cents per piece. And then for over 12 months and things for like the older like toddler clothes, I don't like to spend more than like 50 cents, 75 cents, or a dollar on those pieces. Now, if it's a really, really nice piece or something that we're missing from our wardrobe that I would really like for my daughter to have, the budget is flexible, but I always make sure that I have that budget set before I go, so I stick to the amount that we have to spend on our kids' clothes. And by buying used and like using a budget and things, we've actually had more money to spend on different items that we have needed, or after we had my daughter, we found out we needed this, this, and this, so we had the money to get that since we didn't spend a whole bunch of money on clothes. We do buy some clothes at like stores brand new. What we try to do when we're purchasing clothes at a store is make sure you hit up the clearance racks or see about end of season. If your child could wear it possibly the next year at that season, you can always like buy ahead, buy sizes bigger, so that way you have it for the next year. And then the next season, look at the end of season clothes, because you can find clothes for a reduced price, so you don't have that big price tag for clothes. And my other like tip for buying clothes is make sure that you're buying clothes that like don't go out of style. Like it's not something that's just in this year, and by the time your child wears it or something like that, you may or may not use it because it won't be in style or whatever you want to call it. We don't buy a lot of like movie themed like shirts because you never know if they're going to be into that in the future or if that will be popular anymore. We have bought like several things that are like Mickey and Minnie Mouse because my daughter loves that. She likes like Toy Story and she likes Disney princesses, so we have bought some of those things that we know that she likes and that she will like in the future as well. So another thing with buying clothes is how we kind of decide how many we need of something is I've found that these numbers work best for our family. So we have an everyday like category of clothes, and that is like tops and bottoms that are just for everyday wear, just for like going outside, getting dirty, staying at home, going on a play date where we're going to be playing with something that's like not so like clothing friendly, or if we're having spaghetti or something again that will stain easily. We have like an everyday like category, and we usually try to buy about 10 outfits of like in the everyday category. For nice outfits, we do buy about 5 nice outfits per like age group of like clothing, and that is because if we are going to like different events, but it's all with the same family, like my daughter can wear something different to each event. Now, some people don't really care, but what I like my daughter to wear different outfits to different events for is so that way I can look at a picture that we took at that event and say, oh, like she was wearing this, so this is where we were at. And like that kind of helps me do like a timing kind of thing, like when I'm looking at pictures, be like, okay, well she wore that to that graduation, or she wore that to that wedding, or she wore that to the funeral, or just something like that. Okay, so for PJs, we usually try to buy 4 sets of PJs, or like 4 like PJ like outfit kind of things, and those will get us, so our kids can wear like a different pair of PJs every night, and those numbers help us get us to the next wash day. So, and like the 10 outfits for like everyday use, where if there's like spills or something happens to them, then we have another outfit we can like throw our kids in like that same day and still make it to wash day. Another thing that we buy multiples of is jackets. We usually buy 2 or 3 like jackets in each age group, but we usually only buy like 1 coat for whatever size they will be in for like the fall and winter like months. So we usually buy our outfits again ahead. So we look what we try to like do some like telling the future and trying to see whether my daughter and my son will be like fall, winter, spring, or summer when they're going to be wearing that. Now my son is 6 months old and he's already in 12-month clothes. So he is going to be in his 18-month clothes like this winter. So I'm so happy that I bought long sleeve stuff for him in 18 months at our yard sales and stuff that I went to earlier this year. So he will have those clothes already. We also do like trading of clothes. My friends or whatever gave us tons of clothes for my son. Again, as I said, we have given clothes to other people who have like had a girl or a boy that need those clothes. So we do a lot of like trading or giving clothes. Selling, I do sell some items. If I cannot find somebody to give them to, I will sell like dresses. My daughter wore a dress to one of my friend's weddings, and our future kids won't, if we have a future girl, if baby number 3 ends up being a girl, we'll get her a different like special occasion dress to wear. But so we like sold that. We sell like Halloween costumes because I want my kids to wear like different Halloween costumes. Obviously we have 1 girl and 1 boy. So storing an inventory, that is one thing that I am a big, huge like advocate for, is making sure that you are storing your clothes. And how best to store, sorry, there's a fly in here. How best to store newborn clothes, or even like newborn to 6 months. What we found out with my daughter, when we pulled all of her clothes out from storage, like her newborn clothes for my son to wear, we found that by just having the newborn clothes in a bin, which is what we store all of our kids' clothes in, but the yellow from like spit up and things like that was actually starting to come out. So we had to do like peroxide and like bleach and like to get those yellowish stains out. Well, what we did with my son's 0 to 6 month clothes is we put them in vacuum storage bags, and that is how I recommend to everybody to store their infant clothes. If you're going to be using them for your next child, or if you're just storing them until you can like sell them, make sure you're doing like a vacuum storage bag. That way those yellowish stains won't come through. But again, we store all of our clothes in bins, and we store the ahead clothes that we're buying ahead in bins also, and they're all labeled as to like what size they are. And that's another tip for buying ahead, is the label is not always accurate. So what I actually do is I put piece on piece and size up the clothes. So that way you have all the same size of shirts. Like for instance, one of the like rompers that my son has. Well, one is 12 months and one is 18 months, but they are the exact same size. So my son actually is fitting into some of the 18 month stuff that is the same size as the 12 month clothes. So that is another thing. You can't always go by labels. You can't always go like brand to brand. Sizes and stuff tend to be different. So just how we care for our clothes, again, with the newborn clothes, storing them in vacuum, like saver bags is a very good idea. Again, we had to learn that the hard way. But another thing for care is pre-treating. Make sure if there's a stain on your clothes or on your kids' clothes when you take them off of them, make sure you are spraying them with some sort of pre-treater. And if your clothes are, if your kids' clothes are wet or damp or something, spread them out like over the edge of the hamper or something to dry. Or if they have pre-treater on them, just, and it's not laundry day, just spread them over the top of the hamper to dry. Because we had to learn this the hard way as well with my daughter. We had a few bibs that were wet that got thrown on the bottom of the hamper. And when we came to do laundry 3 days later, the bibs had molded and we had to throw them out, and we threw away the clothes that were sitting on top of them as well, because mold can spread. So make sure that any damp clothes are being dried before like they get other clothes piled on top of them, and make sure that you are using a soap that is like friendly to your kids' skin. Always like fragrance free and dye free are always good for washing your clothes, for your kids' clothes, so that way they don't have any reactions to any of like the soap, detergent, or anything like that. Always follow your care instructions on your label, and make sure that if you're supposed to hand wash an item, just hand wash it. We learned that the hard way. We're just like, oh, we're just gonna throw it in, it'll be fine. And some of the like tooling and stuff that was on one of my daughter's shirts came off. It was supposed to be hand washed. So again, we learned that the hard way. If it says hand wash, just hand wash it. But to kind of like sum everything up, we love to keep things as simple as possible, and we love to save money on, especially on clothes. And when they're little, they go through clothes so quickly and they don't wear a particular size for very long. The first size that my daughter actually wore for almost an entire year was her 2T clothes. And then her 3T clothes she wore for about a year as well. And now again, she is in like 4T stuff. So the younger like kids' clothes, like the infant clothes, I would just so suggest buying those used. Now, how we're going to do things in the future, and this is just like just a little tidbit here, is for my daughter's school clothes, we will buy those new. That is one thing that we did when I was younger, is like our school clothes that we wore to school, we always got to go buy those new, and it was such a great feeling that they got to pick out whatever they want and just like have that self-confidence and things like that for like picking out your own clothes. Now, my daughter does go with us to garage sales and things like that. And she does tell me if she likes something or not, which is fabulous that she can do that now, because I have her bought all the way up to like size 6 or extra small. But we will still continue to buy used clothing as long as our like community sales and things have those clothes to purchase. But anyways, I think that is it for my mommy tips on clothing. Please leave a comment below if you have any questions or comments. But yes, anyways, I will see you tomorrow for Veda Day number 25. Bye, guys.